last year with ups and downs. Mike, could you just talk a little bit about your junior year?
Well, my junior year was tough. I mean, had a couple of bumps and bruises every now and then, you know, just like any college athlete would have. You know, wasn't quite the season I wanted to be, but hey, you know, things happen for a reason.
So I said you added some muscle, bulked up. Is that something you intentionally
did? Or? Yeah, I mean, just bulked up in different places, you know, just to, you know, to eliminate any injuries in certain places, you know, that's all.
Have you seen the schedule yet?
Yes, I have. Very excited.
Without looking at individual games, how exciting is it just to see the roadmap for next year?
It's very exciting, I mean, because that's the road to success, and that's the road I'm trying to take, so I'm happy to see it, you know.
I forgot my question.
That's it? All right.
No. George, we have to wait for George's question.
Come on, get it together.
I'll probably remember
tomorrow. Just about Steven sitting out, I mean, just how are his feelings? Obviously, I know he wanted to try to compete with the job open.
Yeah, I mean, Steven's a competitor. You know, he wants to be in there, but, I mean, the best thing for him to know is to take a step back and relax and, you know, become a better leader, you know, vocal leader. So, you know, everything happens for a reason, like I said. So, hopefully, Steven take advantage of the situation and make the best out of it.
What did you think of Lamar's 40 time in the combine?
He texted me in between his 40s, actually, to tell me, like, he was like, I did bad, bro. I was like, you know what I'm saying? He ran 4.38 on the official, so it was good. But, I mean, it wasn't quite what he wanted to run, but I'm sure he's going to run at the pro day. So,
What do you think he could do? What do you think he's capable of?
I'm thinking low 4.3, high 4.2. So, that's just me, because I've been working with him every day. But, you know, he was battling some things at the combine, you know. I mean, he didn't get a good start. He didn't finish like he wanted to, but, you know, he's still the fastest man there, so that says something.
How much of it did you see your other buddies from the team last year?
I watched the whole thing. I watched the whole thing. Everybody, every drill, everything. So it was good. They did a good job.
Sorry, man. Coach Golden mentioned that you had given up your December and January to work out. Mm-hmm. What was he talking about exactly? And is that something different from the way you've gone about things the last few years?
I usually would go home over the break, you know, enjoy family and work out at home. But I figure, you know, it's really time to give it all up, you know. I mean, we talk about things on the team, you know, about giving up personal lives. And, you know, we read books over the break, and I read a couple things, and I listened to a couple speakers, you know. And it's all about, you know, if you want to be successful, how bad do you want it? You know, what are you willing to give up? You know, so, you know, I was just willing to give up, you know, my extra time and, you know, things like that to make myself better and help this team. So, you know, I stayed over break. You know, I enjoyed myself. I was here with Swayze, working out every day. So, I mean, it helped.
Who else were you proud of from your team that you think did the same sort of thing, sacrificed, gave up their time? Who'd you see?
Brandon Linder, McDermott, Rary Armstrong, AJ Highsmith stayed for a little bit. So, you know, we got some guys on the team that's really mature and really starting to understand, you know, we'll do anything to win, and, you know, that's what we're trying to do.
Coach made a comment. He said, you know, you guys played on the 6-16. He coached the 6-16. Is it kind of lending itself to what you're sort of saying? People realize how difficult it is to win and what the sacrifices that
Most definitely. Realize that, you know, winning in college football is hard. No matter who you beat, no matter who you lose to, I mean, it's hard. So you got to prepare yourself every week to do so. And if that means comparing ourselves now, you know, to get ready for the season, that's what we have to do.
And you mentioned Dallas as an X factor. You did some wildcatting last year. Can you see him in packages back there?
Yeah, I mean,
Steven or Ryan,
you know, with throwing the ball with these guys, you know, with these guys we got, this talent we got on this team, you can see guys anywhere. So, you know, I mean, I don't know yet where he's going to be put at, what all he's going to do, but he's going to be excited.
Any more questions for Michael?
Lamar had, you know, nearly 1,300 yards last year, one of the best seasons ever. Do you think you could come close to that, Mike? I mean, was that
a
goal?
Yeah, that is a goal, but that's a goal and another goal as in winning. You know, what is 1,300 yards by a national championship? No, not Lamar, but, you know, with anybody, you know, what's all these personal accolades without winning?
Right.
You know, it's nothing, so.